In this vlog, let's continue with the concept of Flutter hooks. In continuation to our previous vlogs where we have discussed few hook concepts like useState, useEffect and useMemoize. So these are the three concepts we have covered till now as a part of Flutter hooks, and useState I have tried to explain you with a basic counter example. So this is the link for the tutorial. Here you are finding it in the icon. So you can just go through it for more details on this particular useState implementation. And the second one we have covered is like useEffect. This particular hook we have made use to avoid initialization and disposing. So using this particular useEffect, we have avoided init and dispose block of code. We have tried to initiate a timer to update a value to demonstrate this particular useEffect. So for more information, you can go through this particular tutorial. Link in the icon here. And also the third one is like useMemoize. So this particular hook is used to cache the instance of an object. So we have tried to create an object and we have tried to call the object multiple times. We have tried to make use of the object multiple times. So to avoid the delay for the time taken to process, we have made use of a cache there. So this particular concept we have explained in this part of the tutorial here. So the link is available in the icon. So these are the three concepts till now we have covered, and for this tutorial we will be going to deal with useRef. So we are going to see a small intro before getting to the tutorial. So now let's try to observe the few changes which I would like to show you in this part of the intro here. So these are only few basic changes. There are a few more changes which we will be covering in the tutorial. So now let's try to see the differences here. So the first one is useState, and we will be comparing it with our useRef here. So the first change we are going to observe is like we can create a variable here and get notified on the changes. So as we have covered in a tutorial on useState, there I have clearly explained you with a counter example where whenever we tap on a button, so there is a change in the value. So that particular value will be notified onto our text widget, and in place of useRef here, an object that contains a single mutable property. So here we can make the change, but here it will not be displayed onto our screen. So what is that? What is the main difference here we can observe in useState and useReference is here we are creating a variable here and we are getting notified on the changes. Notified in the sense we are able to re-render it onto the screen. But in useRef, we are not going to re-render, but we are able to observe the change over there even. So here, the second point is just we have discussed will re-render once there is any change. So for example, whenever you tap on a button, so the initial value is 0, and when you tap for the first time, it will be incremented to 1, 3 and so on. So whenever there is any change in the value, so every time it will re-render and it will display the new number onto our screen. So this is what we covered with a counter example. And in terms of useRef here, it will not re-render. But don't think like it will not update or increment the value. It will increment the value here even, but it will not render the output onto our screen. In the next vlog, I will be clearly covering this. In terms of a simple application, I will be showing you, I will be demonstrating you how useState and useRef works. So don't get confused here. So in further coming tutorial, you will be getting a good knowledge on the differences between useState and useRef. So the third point is like useState will remember the data and even useRef will also remember the data. That is, the data will be same in both the cases. The data will be incremented, decremented, and whatever the changes you make will be same there. But the only change here is like it will not get re-rendered in terms of useRef, and it will be getting re-rendered in terms of useState. And again, these two things have their own importance here. So you might think why we need to use useRef here and why we need to use useState. They both are having their own advantages when it comes to real world programming. And here used to store and update the data through the render cycle here. So through the render cycle, you are trying to store the data and you are trying to update the data. So this is again the same point which we have seen in the above things. So we are storing the data and updating the output. So sometimes in your application, you need to update the user with the new data coming up. So you are getting data continuously from a server or an API, and you want to display the data onto the screen so that the user will know the things happening. So just like a live cricket score, things like this, you want to display to the user as and how you get them. So in this particular situations, you can make use of a useState over there, and useRef is where you can store the data through entire lifecycle of a component. So here the data will be available through the entire lifecycle of the component, but this will not be displayed or re-rendered as in case of useState, but this will be stored in background so that you can use it later. So basically you will use useRef to maintain the state when there are multiple re-renders. So this is the basic usage of useRef here. And again, there are multiple usages as well depending upon your application requirement. So the basic usage is to maintain the state when you are having multiple re-renders. Okay, so the useRef will maintain it by creating an object that will maintain a single mutable property. So these are the basic differences between a useState and useRef. And in the coming tutorial, I will be demonstrating you the usage of these two things in our application level. So yes, this is it for this tutorial. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.